I'm so sleepy. Excuse how I look. You think since I've been like not posting for like three weeks? I'm not counting the last couple videos because those honestly have been bullcrap videos. So we're not gonna count those. But you would think that since I basically haven't posted any good content in like a month, that I would come on here looking decent. Welcome to the Ant Bar. So this video, as you seen by the intro, if I haven't switched it up, because I made an intro, but I don't know if I like completely like it. But I don't normally do stuff like that. Like all the intros that I've had made, like I haven't made them, so. That was my first time making something like that. But when I woke up this morning, I had a text from my mom. I said our deep freezer in the garage wasn't working, so we had to throw all the food out in there. So that's that. And then today is the day after Thanksgiving. So it's like Black Friday. But and my mom wants me to go to Rack Room. Because there were these boots I liked, and there were these boots she liked, and there was like buy one, get one free. So I'm gonna go do that. And then she wants me to go to Pop Shelf to look for a tree skirt. Oh, two tree skirts. So that's on the agenda. And I just thought I would bring you guys along, and this will be Vlogmas day one. Hopefully, we can do good, because today is already the, 26th? So. I'm so sleepy, I don't want to get up. Okay, y'all, I'm ready. I'm about to head out the house. I have on this Nirvana shirt from Walmart. These H&M jeans. So we about to leave. Don't mind my bed not being made. We probably, when I get back, I'm gonna hop right back in the bed. So there's no point in me making the bed. So grab my water. My wallet is in the car. Shut this. And I was gonna take the boys with me, but it's just probably easier for me just go do it by myself because landing in public. Okay, I'm in the car now. What I need is some gas. But when I be watching other people and they be like, I have 18 miles left, I'm like, that's not safe because the car could easily just stop. But first stop I'm gonna make is CVS because I have to pick up Landon's medicine for my mom. Yeah, I hardly ever go anywhere by myself. Like, if I'm making like little runs, like errands for my mom, I most likely have the boys with me. So this is kind of weird. But today is like Black Friday. Let me not hit that car. So my mom was like, it'll probably be better if you just go by yourself. So you don't have to worry about them. Because Linda and Asia love to fight in the stores. Like, they love to fight in the stores and try to embarrass me and just do the most. So she probably was telling the truth, but I'm just not used to be by myself when I'm running errands at all. But I'll talk to y'all when, I don't know, I think I'm gonna go to CVS, Pop Shelf, and then Rack Room. That just seems the easiest. Y'all, I'm literally not gonna be able to film in here at all. It is so packed, like so packed. And there was already a line like coming out of Rack Room. So I know I'm not gonna be able to film in here. I am so sorry. I've never been Black Friday shopping before, let alone by myself. And I'm not even doing much shopping. I'm just going in here for two pairs of shoes. And it's this crazy. So I would just have to see y'all when I get home. Sorry, I'm not even gonna do that to myself. And I'm by myself. What is all over me? Oh my gosh. Can you see that on my shirt? It's like a bunch of the stuff that was on that Christmas tree skirt. Oh my gosh, that is unfortunate. Okay, let's go in here and let's get out. And I'm gonna bring my AirPods because I might need to call my mom because I honestly forgot which shoes she wanted. Y'all, right now I'm getting gas and I finally learned how to do the thing by myself, like the little thing where like you don't have to pump it. My dad and Taryn both tried to show me, and my mom, but it wasn't clicking. But I guess since I was by myself, like I learned to do it, I guess. But yeah, after this, I'm going to the house because I'm so tired. Me and Taryn may be going out tonight. I don't know. We haven't made our minds up about like what we want to do, where we want to go. So when I get home, I need to call him so we can discuss that. I stopped by Dollar Tree too because my mom wanted me to look for like some flowers that we can put in our own Christmas tree, and what she wanted wasn't there, so I just got me a Hershey. The car's not even on and I'm trying to go somewhere. Love that for me.
So as you can see, I literally have this big old load of clothes to fold. So I suppose I just kind of fold them. But I'm actually be sitting down. I normally don't sit down and fold clothes because I feel like I fold them faster when I'm standing up. But I'm cramping because I'm on my period. So we just gonna sit down. We gonna take it easy. I'm actually going to take this time to, instead of time lapse it, like just talk to y'all, because I feel like we actually haven't talked in a minute, and kind of just gonna catch y'all up on stuff that y'all been missing out on. Because like when I go ghost on y'all for however long it may be, I haven't been like really telling y'all why or what has been causing that. But well, the month of November has actually been quite busy. Like senior stuff is like really cracking down, I don't know, it's been a lot. So that's been stuff to deal with. I've also been trying to keep my grades up. I'm doing pretty good now. I just have one C, and that's English, which is actually quite surprising because English has been my best subject like in all 4 years of high school. But English 4 is really a lot of history and not more so English, if you know what I mean. And if you've taken English 4, then you probably know what I mean. But yeah, so that's been that. And I also haven't been like the best mentally. I mean, there's really not much to say about it. I just haven't been me. But I've been trying to, that's why I wanted to kind of give myself a break in the month of November, because I felt like I was trying to do so much. And I'm only one person, and one person can only do so much. And you know, at the beginning of the school year, I was working, and then I stopped working in September. Not because it was too much. I was actually planning to find another job. It just, I didn't like the people anymore. Like, they were actually quite, they were draining. Like, they were, I would go to work and like want to cry because like they were just, their energy was so draining. And I doubt they'll ever see this, and if they do, I honestly don't care. But I'm just saying, like, they were draining to be around. And most of them were grown. That's the crazy part about it. But yeah. So that was that. So I quit working there in like the beginning of September. And I was planning to find a better paying job because they were only paying me $8 an hour. And I'm not trying to sound ungrateful because any money is better than no money. But for me to be there like dang near every day, the money just was not adding up. especially during the summertime. Like, I was literally there 5 days out of the week during the summertime. So, it just, I don't know, it just wasn't giving to me. So, that's why I wanted to quit and find another job. But once I quit, my dad, he's really the one that doesn't really want me working. He wants me to enjoy my senior year. And I appreciate having parents like that, but it's like the independency, is that a word? The urge in me to like want to not have to depend on anybody is like so, so high. So like, I don't really like asking them for money. I don't like asking them for, can I have this or can I get this? Because, I mean, even when I was working, they would still give me money here and there. But it wasn't as much. And I mean, I'm not being ungrateful. I'm just saying I really like doing stuff on my own. Like, I like being able to go shopping whenever I want it or go order my whole Shein cart on Shein. But honestly, I'm not having money all the time. Where are these, my mom's or my dad's? I don't know. They don't have a tag. Do they? I don't think my mom was on my dad's. I don't know. Because I don't think my mom was 2XL. I don't know. But anyway. Like I was saying, I just miss doing stuff on my own, but not having a job. And actually looking back and realizing that, like, a lot of that stuff, like, for the age that I am, I feel like I'm trying to rush my life because I'm seeing so many people on the internet, like, have all this at 17 years old, 18 years old, because I'm about to be 18. Well, when you're watching this, it'll be this month, but I'm recording this in November. So, I feel like that's why I feel like I have to be farther than what I am. But in reality, God has a plan and a path for everybody. And my path is not the same as someone else's. So not having a job has really taught me patience and just to let it be. Like, let whatever it is, just let it be. Like, don't try to rush your life, you know? So, but I'm very, very thankful and fortunate to have parents that aren't trying to rush me out or trying to rush me to go get a job and, like, get off of their plates. You know, even though I try to make it like as easy as possible on my parents, but senior year, y'all, is so freaking expensive. Like, we just found out about prom. Tell me why the tickets are $50. And me and Taryn, we don't go to the same school. I don't know if y'all know that, but we don't. It's $50 regardless, but literally he has to basically go through a freaking background check to be able to go to prom. So, that's that. Prom is like in March, so we literally I don't have that long to be preparing. What the world? So we're really just hoping that I could get everything in order like I want it to be. But I'm just not too stressed about it because I have a lot of things already online. So that's something that I want to stress about, but I know it'll come out how it should, so I'm not going to stress too much about it. But other than that, like, it's basically me not being on YouTube was really just because I wasn't there mentally. Like, I felt like I don't need to be coming on here faking. And those last couple videos, I don't know, you probably could tell, you probably couldn't, because I kind of am good at like hiding when I'm feeling a certain way. Unless you're like my parents or Taryn, then you probably, like, I probably hid how I really feel. Like, if, say, if I'm having a good day, I don't know, something about my parents and Taryn, like, they just know when I'm lying, so there's actually no point in lying to them. I might as well just go ahead and tell them what's wrong. But I just wasn't there mentally, so I was like, I don't need to come on YouTube and act like I'm okay. And honestly, if I can just, like, those months, if I could have just backed away from literally everything, I probably would have. But, you know, I didn't have that choice. In my last year of high school, we're going to make the best of it. At least try to. And literally, like, everyone says how senior year is so fun, but it's actually been quite terrible, if we're being honest. I've still been trying to make the best of it. I don't know. Things have not just been going my way. But I do have good news. If you follow me on Instagram, I didn't make like a big post about it. I just shared it on my story. But if you see that sign right there, it says I'm in, and it says Lander University. So I will be attending.
Who's outside?
Who?
Somebody's running over there.
Girl, I don't want visitors. I don't want visitors. Okay, guys, I'm back. It was Amazon at the door. AJ orders some like nose ring things that you just like, because I don't know if I really want my nose pierced, and I just don't want to be putting holes in my body. Like, I don't care about piercings at all. I really do want more. I think my nose. But girl, this is actually kind of scary. Like, what if I sniff it up? I don't know if a nose ring fits me. And if you wonder, I hate you. I do. Yeah, I don't know if this fits me. I don't know. I forgot what I was talking about. I think I was talking about college. Cause this one's a butterfly. Oop. Okay, that one's too big. Yeah, it just fell on my nose. See, that's too loose. I think this side of my, I don't know. And this one is a heart. This one was a star. I lucky kind of like this one more. I don't know, we're just gonna let it sit right there. Yeah, I don't think nose piercings are for me. I don't know. It'll take something to get used to. But on my 18th birthday, I do plan on, I don't think I'm getting any piercings. Cause I really, honestly, only piercing that I want is an industrial. But I don't know if I'll be able to get that because I start clinicals in January at the hospital. And I don't know if they're gonna, let me put the bra under it. I don't know how they're gonna feel about a big bar in my ear. So, but anyway, back to college. I've decided to further my education at Lander University. And my major is nursing. So that's really like the biggest thing, but that happened like recently, like 2 weeks ago. Y'all saw where I went and toured. I mean, y'all haven't seen much because I honestly couldn't like record much. The tour was actually kind of fast paced. The only things that I really wanted to see were the dorms and then the nursing building, which felt like a mini hospital, which I loved. So yeah, that was that. And then besides that, it really, like, me being gone really was, I'm not finna blame it on my mental health, because I feel like I'm proud of myself for taking the time that I did to myself and figuring out, like, trying to figure out the roots of what was happening. And I'm just glad. I'm feeling much better, like, so way, 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 way better. Kind of happy. Well, not kind of, but I'm happy, like, to be back feeling like my old self, because for a fat minute, I literally did not know, like, who I was. Like, I don't know, I wasn't me, and I felt like to most people, you wouldn't be able to see that, especially if you don't know me. Because at school anyway, like, especially at my home school, I'm walking around with a RDF because I don't want to be there. Like, I literally hate that school so much. But, baby, I got, like, a semester left. Because after Thanksgiving break, we only have 2 more weeks and then it's Christmas break. So, I literally don't have that much left. And then, we'll be doing clinicals and then prom and then graduation. Like, it's so much. I feel like the second semester is when I gotta stand up because I really can't fold like I want to. But I feel like the second semester is way more fun because the first semester is like you really getting your behind kicked, and that's what it's been doing. But I've been holding my own, and I'm so proud of myself. Like, I feel like I don't give myself enough recognition and like what I deserve, because I deserve everything that God has in store for me. I just feel like sometimes I feel like I don't deserve it. Like, when I got accepted to Lander, I was like, I really did not think I was gonna get accepted there. And then that like just boosted me like 10 more times. Well, times 10 to like go there. Like, girl, you've already got accepted. You love the campus, why not go? And it's only an hour away. And I honestly feel like, I keep telling everybody, I'm like, this is the growth that I need. Like, the hour away to, for me to be by myself and experience things without my parents and my siblings, because literally I don't do anything by myself. And it's not me, I don't think it's the me being scary, I just think it's me not ever having that chance to like take a leap of faith on my own. Like, the biggest change that's ever happened in my life was us moving to where we are currently staying, which we're about to be here, I think, 4 years? Yeah, it'll be four years next year in June. So, but like, I did that with my whole family, so I had them, you know? So, it wasn't, like, it was a big change, but I had people with me. But moving an hour away from my family, who I'm literally so close with, that is a change. And although I'm not trying to rush anything, I am ready. Because I'm ready to have something, like, I'm ready to be around different. Where's AJ's clothes? Is this it? Oh, sorry. I'm ready to be around, like, different people in a new environment. I'm ready to learn new things, experience new things. I'm ready for new opportunities, new space for growth in all aspects, mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually, like, everything. Like, I'm ready for it. I'm not rushing it, but I'm ready for it because I'm ready for something new. If that makes sense. So, that's pretty much what's been going on. Other than that, I've been pretty decent. Like, I'm not back to my full self, but I'm getting there, and I'm proud of me. And like, I finally, like I said, that Vlogmas was gonna be my time to like come back 10 times harder, 10 times stronger. Cause like, I'm starting to feel like me again, and it feels good. Like, it feels good to look in the mirror and know who you're looking at, you know? So that's why I was waiting. And I wasn't really trying to like push myself too hard to come back, because I was like, don't come back if you're not ready to come back. That's why when I was like posting videos like every 2 weeks, I was like, just like don't post them. But I was like, these are good, well, not good videos, but, like, these are videos that I have been posting and like putting out content for the people that want to see it, like for the people that are waiting, you know? So that was that. But like I said, I'm feeling better now. I'm proud of me. And if you were in the same predicament or somewhere near there and you're not totally confident about like branching out, girl, just do it. Like, literally, just do it. But I'm about to put all these clothes up. I honestly don't know if me and Tara are going, we probably won't, which I ain't even mad about because I'm low-key tired. Like, I didn't take a nap earlier when I got back from rec room and stuff. AJ made some chicken quesadillas, and then we were watching this Netflix series. Well, I don't know if it's a series, but it's called A Series of Unfortunate Events. Something like that. It's been on Netflix for a minute. We just started about watching it, but yeah, so after I put all these clothes up, I'm gonna show y'all my boots from rec room, and I make it cute. I kind of want to do my hair. It kind of was done earlier, but I want to put it in the middle part. So I'm gonna put all these clothes up, and I will see y'all in a bit. Y'all, am I the so you know, like, what's it called? She dropped her, Summer Walker, she dropped her album. The only song that I like is Insane and X for a Reason. Other than that,
I don't know. And then she claims she's so over it, but yet she got somebody's name tatted on her, like right here. It's giving young boy. Did Janina do that too? Okay, y'all, so my hair is like, oh, well, not done, but like all the products are in it, so I'm gonna wait for like it to get like hard and like crunchy, and then I'm gonna diffuse it. But I think I'm gonna go ahead and do my edges while I'm waiting. I don't know, but I'm not gonna show that part. But yeah, so I'm waiting for my hair to get like hard and air dry a little bit, and then I'm gonna come back and diffuse it with y'all. And then after I diffuse it, I put this oil in it because it like breaks the gel cast. I think that's what it's called. Not me being a curly girl after I've said that I will never ever be a curly girl. Well, I'm attempting to be. We aren't there yet, but I feel like we're doing pretty good. But what I want to do, I'm gonna need Landon to sit down. What I want to do is try like a protein mask or like a replenishing mask, because I've never tried one of those, and I really want to try the Aztec Healing Clay mask, but I don't know if I should do that now since I have color in my hair. But I should just probably do it with water instead of apple cider vinegar, because I feel like the apple cider vinegar would probably strip the color away and maybe make my hair dry. I don't know. But I know it's like good for your scalp, which I do need some like good scalp treatment. So maybe, I don't know. But I do want to do that for like another video maybe, or just try it in general. So y'all might be seeing that as well too. But I really need to like try a mask in my hair, because I want to see like what it looks like, what my curls look like after. It's been like rejuvenated and replenished and hydrated. Y'all, I just realized I never showed y'all my shoes that I got from. Oh, Lord, I'm sorry. I mean, my booties that I got from Rack Room. Okay, so this is the box that they came. It's upside down. Is it upside down? Yeah, this is the box that they came in. I'm sorry for the such horrible lighting. Hold up. Let me. The only reason I have this is because it's Savannah. Girl, it's like a Fantel ghost store. I don't like when my hair is like this. I look like a wet dog. I hate it. My skin. Look at my eyes. That's so pretty. Girl, I don't know what I'm doing, if we're being very honest. But I'm trying to make a setup and it ain't working. These are the booties, and it very much gives my style. My mom has the same hair, but this very much gives my style. I got them in a size 8 because my mom told me that I should size up, because she wears a size 9 and she said hers felt a little snug. And 8. I would try them on, but I have these on. They're not going to look right, so I'm not going to try them on. But yeah. They're so freaking cute. And the heel honestly ain't that bad. And I'm not a heel wearer at all. Like, literally, when I had to wear heels to homecoming, I was literally dying. My feet decapitated. Alright, decapitated means, like, can decapitated mean, like, just your head, like, off, or, like, everything else off? I should know this by how much true crime I watch, but I don't. I don't. Yeah, let me show y'all this book I just got. I think I told y'all about this book, but at Target the other day, I got this book. It's called You Are a Bad A Word. I haven't started it yet because I'm nowhere near finished with this one. I've only read that much, if you can see the bookmark. But I just wanted to get it because I've heard really good things about that book too. And like I said, I've been getting back into my reading.